The subject of physics of atom and atomic nucleus. Lecture number 16, gamma radiation of nuclei. The figure shows the different types of decay and the penetrating power of the corresponding radiation. Alpha radiation, beta radiation, X-rays, gamma rays, neutrons. Figure 2, the electromagnetic spectrum. Gamma rays region. It has been experimentally established that the gamma radiation is not an independent type of radioactivity, but only accompanies the alpha and beta decays and also arises in nuclear reactions. In the deceleration at charged particles, etc. The gamma spectrum is line spectrum. The gamma spectrum is the distribution of the number of gamma quanta with respect to energies. The discreteness of the gamma spectrum is of fundamental importance, since it is a proof of the discreteness of energy states of atomic nuclei. At present, it is firmly established that the gamma radiation is emitted by the daughter rather than the parent nucleus. The daughter nucleus, at the time of its formation, proving to be excited in the time of about 10 to minus 13, 10 to minus 14 power second, considerably shorter than the lifetime of the excited atom, about 10 to minus 8 power second, passes into the ground state with emission of gamma radiation. Returning of the ground state, the excited nucleus can pass through a series of intermediate states. Therefore, the gamma radiation of a single radioactive isotope can contain several groups of gamma quanta that differ in energy. Excited nucleus with a asterisk mass and relaxed nucleus with mass A. At gamma radiation, A and Z numbers, the nuclei do not change, so it is not described by any displacement rules. The gamma radiation of most nuclei is so short the wave that its wave properties are very weak. Here, the corpuscular properties come to the fore, therefore the gamma radiation is treated as a particle flux of gamma quanta. In the radioactive decays of various nuclei, the gamma quanta have energies from 10 kilo electron volt to 5 mega electron volt. Figure 4 shows as an example of the energy levels of nickel 60. The nucleus, which is in an excited state, can go over the ground state not only when the gamma quantum is emitted, but also when the excitation energy is directly transferred without first emission of gamma quantum to one of electrons of the same atom. The so-called conversion electron is emitted. The phenomenon itself is called internal conversion. Internal conversion is a process competing with gamma radiation. Figure 5, principle of internal conversion. The conversion electrons correspond to discrete values of the energy, which depends on the work function of the electron from the shell from which the electron breaks out and on the energy E given by the nucleus upon transition from the excited state to the ground state. If the entire energy E is released as a gamma quantum, then the radiation frequency nu is determined from the known relation E equals H multiplied nu. If the internal conversion electrons are emitted, then their energies are E minus A sub K, E minus A sub L, where A sub K and A sub L is the work function of the electron from the K and L shells. The monoenergetic nature of the conversion electrons makes it possible to distinguish them from the beta electrons, whose spectrum is continuous. The vacancy due to the emission of the electron on the inner shell of the atom will be filled with electrons from the overlying shells. Therefore, internal convection is always accompanied by characteristic X-ray radiation. Gamma quanta, having a zero rest mass, cannot slow down in the medium. So when gamma radiation passes through matter, they are either absorbed or scattered by it. Gamma quanta do not carry an electric charge and thus do not experience the influence of Coulomb forces. When the beam of gamma quanta passes through matter, the energy does not change, but as a result of collisions, the intensity is weakened. Figure 6. The change of which is attenuated by the exponential law I equals I sub 0 multiplied E minus mu multiplied X. I sub 0 and I, the intensity of the gamma radiation at the entrance and exit of the layer of absorbing substance X. Mu is the absorption coefficient. Since gamma radiation is the most penetrating radiation, then for many substances is a very small value. Mu depends on the properties of matter and on the energy of gamma quanta. Figure 6, attenuation of gamma radiation in the thin layer of the absorber. Gamma quanta passing through matter can interact with both the electronic shell of the atoms of matter and with their nuclei. In quantum electrodynamics, it is proved that the main processes accompanying the passage of gamma radiation through matter are the photoelectric effect, the Compton effect, Compton scattering, and the formation of electron-positron pairs. The photoelectric effect or photoelectric absorption of radiation is a process which an atom absorbs a gamma quantum and emits an electron. Since the electron is knocked out of one of the inner shells of the atom, the vacant space is filled with electrons from the overlying shells, and the photoelectric effect is accompanied by characteristic gamma ray radiation. The photoelectric effect is a predominant absorption mechanism in the low energy gamma quantum region. E sub gamma less and equals then 100 kilo electron volt. The photoelectric effect can only occur on bound electrons, since a free electron cannot absorb the gamma quantum, while the laws of conservation of energy and momentum are not simultaneously satisfied. At the energy of gamma quantum, E sub gamma approximately equals 0.5 mega electron volt, increases, the probability of the photoelectric effect is very small, and the main mechanism of interaction of gamma quantum with the matter is Compton scattering. At energy equals or being or greater than 1.02 mega electron volt equals 2 multiplied mi sub E multiplied C 2 square. Mi sub E is the rest mass of the electron. The process of formation of electron-positron pairs in electric fields of nuclei becomes possible. The probability of this process is proportional to Z square and increases with the increasing E gamma. Therefore, at E sub gamma approximately equals 10 mega electron volt, the main process of interaction of gamma radiation in any substance is formed by electron-positron pairs. If the energy of the gamma quantum exceeds the binding energy of nucleons in the nucleus, 7 to 8 mega electron volts, as a result of the absorption of the gamma quantum, a nuclear photoelectric effect, the ejection from the nucleus of one of the nucleons, most often a neutron, can be observed. The large penetrating power of the gamma radiation is used in gamma defectoscopy. The flow detection method based on the different absorption of gamma radiation when it is propagated to the same distance of different media. The location and size of defects, shells, cracks, etc. are determined by the difference in the radiation intensities passing through different parts of the inspected sample. The effect of gamma radiation as well as other types of the ionizing radiation on the substance is characterized by the dose of ionizing radiation. As already indicated, the discrete spectrum of the gamma radiation is due to the discreteness of the energy levels of the atomic nuclei. However, as follows from the inter-center relation, the energy of the excited states of the nucleus takes values within delta E approximately equals H divided delta T, where delta T is the lifetime of the nucleus in the excited state. Consequently, the smaller delta T, the greater the energy uncertainty delta E of the excited state. Delta E equals zero only for the ground state of the stable core. For it, delta T tends to infinity. The uncertainty of the energy of quantum mechanical system, for example an atom, which has discrete energy levels, determines the natural width of the energy level G. For example, as the lifetime of the excited state equals to 10 to minus 13 power second, the natural width of the energy level is approximately equals 10 to minus 2 electron volt. The uncertainty of the energy of the excited state caused by the finite lifetime of the excited states of the nucleus leads to non-monochromaticity of the gamma radiation emitted when the nucleus passes from the excited state of the ground state. The non-monochromaticity is called the natural width of the gamma radiation light. When passing gamma radiation in the substance, in addition to the process described above, the photoelectric effect, Compton scattering, the formation of an electron-positron pair, should also be observed resonance effects in principle. If the nucleus irradiates gamma rays with energy equal to the difference one of the excited and ground state energy of the nucleus, it may have a resonant absorption gamma radiation. Nucleus absorbs gamma quantum of the same frequency as the frequency of the emitted nucleus gamma photon during the transition nucleus from the given excited state to the ground state. Observation of resonance absorption gamma ray nuclei considered impossible for a long time because the transition nucleus from the excited state of the ground state E, its energy is assumed to be zero. Emitted gamma photon has an energy E sub gamma slightly smaller than E. Due to the recoil nucleus in the process of radiation, E sub gamma equals E minus E sub n, where E sub n is the kinetic energy of the recoil of the nucleus. Upon excitation of the nucleus and its transition from the ground state of the excited energy, E gamma photon must have an energy. E sub gamma asterisk equals E plus E sub n, which E sub n is the recoil energy which gamma quantum must transmit absorbed nucleus. Thus, the maxima of the emission and absorption lines are shifted relative to each other by the value 2 multiplied E sub n, figure number 8. Using the law of conservation, the momentum according to which, in the considered processes of radiation and absorption, the momentum of the gamma quantum and the nucleus shall be equal, we obtain E sub n equals, approximately equals, E square divided 2 multiplied m sub n multiplied c square. Formula number 1, figure 8, emission and absorption lines of gamma ray. For example, the excited state of the iridium isotope 191 iridium has an energy of 129 kiloelectronvolt, and its lifetime is on the order of 10 to minus 10 power second. So the width of the level is G equals approximately equals 4 multiplied 10 to minus power electronvolt. The energy of recoil when emitted from this level, according to formula 1, is approximately equals 5 multiplied 10 to minus 2 power electron volt. It has 3 orders of magnitude greater than the width of the level. Naturally, no resonant absorption under such conditions is possible. To observe the resonant absorption, the absorption line must coincide with the emission line. It also follows from the experiments that resonance absorption is not absorbed on the free nuclei. Figure 9, relative intensity ratio, Mesbauer absorption with iridium 191. The resonant absorption of the gamma radiation can be principally be obtained only by compensating for the energy lost of the recoil of the nucleus. This problem was solved in 1958, Rudolf Mesbauer, Nobel Prize in 1961. He investigated the emission and absorption of gamma radiation in nuclei in a crystal lattice, that is, a bound state. Experiments were carried out at low temperature. In this case, the momentum and the recoil energy are transferred not to one nucleus emitting absorbing a gamma quantum, but to the entire crystal lattice as a whole. Since the crystal has a much larger mass than the mass of individual nucleus, in accordance with formula 1, the energy losses for recoil become vanishingly small. Therefore, the processes of emission and absorption of radiation occur practically without loss of energy, ideally elastic. Figure 10, Rudolf Ludwig Mesbauer. The phenomenon of elastic emission absorption of gamma quantum by atomic nuclei bound in a solid not accompanied by a change of internal energy of the body is called the Mesbauer effect. Under the conditions considered, the emission and absorption lines of the gamma radiation practically coincide and have a very small width, well equal to the natural width, d. The Mesbauer effect was discovered in a deeply cooled iridium. The lattice vibration freezes with decreasing temperature and was subsequently detected by more than 20 stable isotopes, for example, 57th ferrum, 67th zinc. Mesbauer armed the experimental physics with a new method of measuring the previously unknown accuracy. The Mesbauer effect makes it possible to measure the energy frequency of radiation with relative accuracy. G divided E equals from 10 to minus 15 power to 10 to minus 17 power. Therefore, in many areas of sciences and technology, it can serve as a thinnest tool for various key kinds of measurements. It became possible to measure the finest details of the lines, internal magnetic and electric fields in solids, and so on. External effects, for example, Zeeman splitting of nuclear levels or displacement of photon energy when moving in gravitational field, can lead to a very small displacement of either the absorption line or the emission line, and otherwise lead to a weakening or disappearance of the Mesbauer effect. The displacement, therefore, can be fixed. Similarly, in the laboratory conditions such as subtle effect and gravitational redshift, predicted by Einstein's general theory of relativity, was discovered 1960. Figure 12, experiment of measuring the gravitational redshift. The slide shows the literature used. Next slide. Questions to consolidate knowledge. First question. Explain why the gamma ray spectrum has a discrete and not a continuous form. Second. What is the sequence of transformations in the substance when the energy of the gamma quantum increases? Third. Under the what conditions it is possible to observe a nuclear photoelectric effect? First question, what should be done to observe the nuclear gamma resonance? Fifth, Give examples of using Mesbauer spectroscopy. Thank you for your attention.